Well, cooking has to be one of my favourite ways to cook. It's incredibly easy and incredibly quick, but you do need a little bit of technique. So I'm going to take you through the basics of wok cooking. This is a wok. It's got a curved shape, which makes it great because it lets the liquid drip away and collect in the centre where the heat can evaporate it. But liquid is the enemy of a really great stir fry, and I'll show you why. As the liquid runs away from your ingredients and collects in the bottom of the wok, you want to make sure that your burner can evaporate that liquid quickly. That's where the ASCO Volcano comes in. It is the best wok burner for home cooking. It's got three basic functions. Firstly, it's the high intensity wok burner. It's a bit like bouncing a rubber ball. The high intensity volcano burner directs those directly at the base of the wok where you need it the most. Then there's the large general burner. Even though they may have more power, actually shoot onto the curved side of the wok, which reflects the heat away. It's also at a low simmer function for making stocks and sauces and those kind of things. This is how it goes in practice. Put a bit of water in the bottom there. You can see that's boiling there because the volcano wok burner directs the intensity of the flame to where that liquid is. The large burner actually has a higher heat output, but if you watch as I flick it over to that setting, the water stops boiling. It only boils around the edges. That means that the liquid that's pooling in the bottom isn't getting evaporated away and you're stewing instead of frying. So back to the volcano function, and it starts to boil right in the center again. So now you understand why controlling the liquid in your wok is so important. There's a couple of basic things to really understand when you are cooking with a wok. Firstly, keep your stir fries simple. Just 1, 2, 3 ingredients. It shouldn't be a vegetable medley. Try beef and broccoli, chicken and Snoopies, those classic combinations work best. Secondly, never overcrowd the wok. If you overcrowd the wok, there's gonna be too many ingredients letting out all their liquids and juices. You're gonna create too much liquid in the bottom and you're not gonna be able to evaporate it. It's gonna stew instead of frying. Lastly, keep your liquid seasonings to the end. Things like oyster sauce, soy sauce, Shaoxing wine. Add those too early and you're gonna be trying to fight against that liquid the whole way. Leave them to the end. You'll spend most of your time frying and less of your time stewing. And that's it. That's the basics of cooking with the ASCO Volcano Wok Burner.